There's a steel train coming through. I would take it if I could, and I would not lie to you, because Sunday morning soon will come when things would be much easier to say upon the microphone like a boss DJ. But I won't walk up upon the sea like it was dry land. The boss DJ, he ain't nothing but a man. No trouble, no fuss, I know why. It's so nice, I wanna hear the same song twice. It's so nice, I wanna hear the same song twice. Rumors are spreading all over my town, but it's just stones and sticks.
And hello, welcome to Swell Season Surf Radio. I am your co-host, Tyler Brewer, and this is our Arts and Design series, episode 2, with my other co-hosts, Chris Coffin and Chris Labzda. How's it going, Chris and Chris? How's your pie?
All doing right. Great. Loving it. And
we have a freaking rad guest this week. I'm so psyched for this guest. Like, I didn't know much about it. And then when I listened to it, it was just like, oh my God. And then when I started doing more research and looking at his work, and I love collage and everything, and it was so awesome. And so our guest is Ashley Bickerton, this incredible artist who happens to live in Indonesia. And through the modern marvels of the internet, you were able to interview him. And Can you tell our listeners a little bit about this guy? Because they're in for a real treat.
Ashley Bickerton's one of my heroes in the art world. He, like you said, he got up and left and moved to Bali and somehow maintained his dark cred over the years. He has an art career that spans decades. He's an art thoroughbred out of Cal Arts. His practice is painting, sculptural assemblages, pretty diverse, and his own person becomes the subject a lot in the paintings themselves. It goes all the way back to his short film work back at Cal Arts. But he's been surfing the entire time, and he's sort of an inspiration for anyone who's a creative, and how you could maybe make the best out of it and surf and be creative and be successful. So he was an incredible person to interview, I thought.
So I love this interview, you know. So Ashley just so he grew up in the UK though, or no, where did he grow? And you grew up in Barbados, I'm sorry. He grew up in Barbados, then
Africa and you know, like, I think Hawaii. He identifies more as growing up in Hawaii.
But I mean, the guy was so interesting. So there are lots of, you know, one is like, how'd you go about getting this interview? I mean, he's pretty big time, kind of a big deal. Imagine his place smells of rich mahogany.
It looked like it.
Looked like it had a lot of incense and it was like smelling like Bali, which is awesome.
Going off or something, but he, I met Ashley when he was in town meeting with his gallery, Lehman Maupin. And I'm helping curate a show at Florida Atlantic University she's going to be a part of. And he happened to be in town, so I was able to set up, not an interview, but just a conversation if he'd be interested, which it was. I didn't know that he hadn't been in the States for a decade, that he had only spent 4 months in the past 20 years back in New York, so I felt kind of privileged after hearing that he spent that decade. But it was great to get him on the interview after the fact.
Yeah, it's incredible. One of the other things I just want to point out, what I love the most is both of you and your nerdiness and your excitement and enthusiasm during this interview, and the knowledge you both possess. You know, it reminds me of my surfy kind of nerdiness. You know, you just geek out and you hear little rumors, and you both were like, "Oh, is that time when you were this or that?" And it's just I love that. I think yeah. it comes through really nicely. I'm really happy about
I think Ashley really enjoyed it too. I really think that like I mean surfing's a great jumping off point. If you're a surfer, I think it's just kind of like you're instantly your friend, you know, and that's where you start the dialogue. But the fact that, like, you know, being a surfer, being an artist, being a curator, being creative people, we could just kind of bounce off all of these different things. And I think he was just excited to tell his story. And God, I was interested to listen because some of the stories that he told were just unbelievable, unbelievable.
Never heard them before.
Yeah.
No.
What's nice about this platform that you're allowing us to participate in, Tyler, is that it's people who do surf immediately feel comfortable because it's not in that art realm. It's more in the surfing realm. And they're like, oh, like, you want to hear about this from this perspective. And they identify with that. Like, specifically Ashley, he is a surfer in his core and everything else kind of stems from that. He's an artist and everything else. But he felt incredibly comfortable. I felt in this interview to just open up and say things that, you know, I haven't heard him speak about in any other interview, which is quite cool.
Do you think it's because their inspiration, a lot of the influence on their art stems from surfing, and if they were to try to explain those influences or the things that they experience to a non-surfer, you could almost feel like it sounds hokey or cringy, but because you're in the company of surfers, it allows you to freely express, as you know, the people you're talking to understand that influence.
Absolutely, but I he's so articulate it came across just
right. Yeah.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, that guy, he could tell a story really well.
Well, you know what's interesting about surfers and artists is that, and I know Chris will definitely agree with me, is that, like, there's this terminology that, like, all kind of people have studied art history or art theory. It's called art speak, and if you have art speak, then you understand the dialogue and the verbiage and the definitions, and it's like you immediately have this shorthand with each other that you don't really need to say everything you need to say because you just intrinsically know what you're talking about. Right. And I think it's the same way with surfers. Like, we have a dialogue, mm-hmm. we have a speak. And when, you know, you're talking, when you use the terminologies that we do, we feel comfortable with each other. So I think on both levels, you know, I think we were able to connect with Ashley in a surfing sense and in an artistic sense.
Guys, you did. This was such a great episode and another, you know, great addition to the series. I'm excited to see where you take this next. So let's keep it up and psyched on this. And any of you guys want to take it out this time?
No, man, it's all you,
Chris. Nah. All right. Well. Here we are, Ashley Bickerton with Chris and Chris for our art and design series. Enjoy, and we'll check you on the other side. You feeling the same way too? I wanna ride it with you, girl, girl, girl.
All right, you guys both surf, right?
Correct.
Yeah. Yep.
Something weird is going on here right now. I've never seen anything like it. I was just down at the beach doing an interview for a magazine yesterday. Yeah. It was like five guys out, like perfect 6 foot, just razor edged. I mean, everywhere it's empty. Nobody's here. And it's one of the like all time seasons ever. And I can't surf.
Why can't you go out?
During COVID, I was stuck in LA and thought somewhere along I'd pulled my shirt out, trying to surf at Christmas in Hawaii, and I hate tow surfing and now I'm never going to do it again. And so I kind of let my arm convalesce, and while I was doing that, I decided to let my knee convalesce, which is a bit of a bum knee. So basically I did nothing. And at 61 years old, if you don't do anything, I found out the hard way. So even though I started training toward the end to get my shoulder ready, and then started doing some yoga, and then when I got here, I started doing some paddling in the pool. It was an unmitigated disaster. I went out on a small day. I could not do a pop-up. I couldn't get up. I didn't have the juice in my legs from sitting around doing nothing for 6 months. I didn't have the juice. So I've been going mad sort of trying to do pop-ups and burpees and paddling mad laps of the pool. But I think I'm going to try again tomorrow. But, I mean, like,
if you still have that I'm a personal trainer also. Okay. If you still have that like inflammation in there and you're trying to go at it thinking that like all of this extra activity is going to help your situation, it may not. I mean, the inflammation and the micro tears might still be in there. So you might want to, I hate to say it.
No. It's not the hurt. The hurt's not in any of the places. It's not in the knee or the shoulder. The shoulder is more or less better.
Right.
So I thought I was ready. It's that I have no juice. I can't get up.
The energy, yeah.
Right.
Yeah, I don't have any core strength. I don't have any leg strength. I mean, I basically sat on my ass for 6 months, and I haven't done that in 20 years, 25
yeah.
years.
Yeah. Lesson and, learned.
I mean, it's a shocker. I thought, you know, usually even if I go 3 months, 3 months is different to 6 months. Big difference.
And, you know,
at 61 years old, it don't come back. I mean, it goes away, and you gotta reel it back. So I'm gonna try tomorrow. See what happens. But I've been doing.
What you're saying, there's nobody out. There's nobody. Do you think that's because of COVID? Do you think it's because?
Less
travelers.
All the tourists who were here got emergency day visas when they shut down the airport. And, a lot of them have stayed. A lot of them were forced to stay. They had no choice because the airports were shut down. There was no travel. All international travel was
banned. Yeah.
So they were stuck here. They got emergency visas. And they had nothing to do but bloody surf. If you look at the surf videos like Surfers of Bali, the surfing now is so on point because everybody's been surfing every fucking day. And it's just perfect. Endless day after day after day. You know, and... the premier breaks like Bingen and Penang are still somewhat crowded, but I'm hoping that people are going to, they're not going to open up till tourists till September 11th. And people, I think August 12th, a lot of visas, that these emergency stays expire, not all, but some. So a lot of people are going to have to go. And plus I think people, now that there's flights out, you know, they got jobs and families, they got to kind of crawl back wherever the hell they came from. So it's going to get less and less, and it's going to be like 1 month of, and I just got to be ready. Okay, I can't.
Yeah, you've got to get ready because when they clear out, it's going to be all yours.
Oh man,
it's like way less crowded than Mentawai. The Mentawais are way more crowded than this in a regular year. This is like, I mean, this is unprecedented. This is once in a lifetime. This is like stories you hear when like some famous spot got rained in. I'm blocked, and so the same crew had it for like a week when some cyclone parked off. You know, you hear stories about that old days in Byron Bay.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I wanted to kind of we have kind of like an itinerary here.
No, it's okay.
you actually jumped ahead to something that like Chris and I were talking about yesterday that you know, we can talk about art all day. We're all three of us are artists, and we'll get to that. But I think one of the things that interests me very much is I saw an interview online where you talked about this this struggle of identity between being an artist and being an athlete. And you were talking about, you know, the making of art, and then you were talking about your hobby, and you're like, my hobby's surfing. And then you were explaining like how it's very difficult to explain to people how, you know, being an athlete is very exclusive, and you see yourself as an athlete and as a surfer. And sometimes maybe the artists don't understand that this is what you do. And I think Chris and I talked about that because Chris is a surfer, and he has a background as an athlete, as a lacrosse player. Yeah. And I'm a surfer, and I have a background as a collegiate swimmer. So, you know, I want you to talk.